I am Eugene De La Cruz, and I am 20 years old. I'm a college student and also a servant leader. Dahil hindi ako sigurado sa sarili ko, hindi rin ako sigurado sa paglilingkod ko. And this is my confession. Good day.
Hello po.
Thank you for coming. Kumusta ka?
Ayos naman po.
Okay, great. No, before perhaps we begin with your story, I'd like to assure you that this is not only a safe space, but also a free, open, and welcoming one. So just feel free to say anything, and I am just here listening.
So, ako po ay part ng LGBTQ community.
Uh-huh.
And recently lang po ako nag-out, and recently ko lang din po na-discover yung sarili ko. And even before that po kasi, when I was in elementary school and up until in high school, I was bullied as I parang manifest po yung mga, yung feminine side ko po.
Mm-hmm.
Doon po sa mga kaklase ko, sa mga nakaka-interact ko.
Uh-huh.
And then, I just discovered myself when I was in college or senior high school.
Uh-huh.
And then, since nga po, lagi ako nabubuli, parang, yun din po yung naging parang turning point ko na parang mag-explore beyond dun sa concept na ang gender ay lalaki at babae lang.
Mm-hmm.
So, ako po ay nag-explore mm-hmm. since katulad, parang feeling ko po kasi yun din naman po kasi yung ano eh, yung parang kadalasang ginagawa ng mga college student.
Okay.
Exploration talaga.
Yes.
And then, ngayon po, I'm already in college.
Mm-hmm.
So, nag-start po yun siguro mga 3 years ago po.
Mm-hmm.
3 years ago po ako, nung nag-out po ako sa parents ko
mm-hmm.
na I'm a pansexual and I'm part of the LGBTQ community.
Uh-huh.
And then, may mga several times na po akong nagkaroon ng relationship with the same sex po.
Uh-huh.
And dun po sa mga relationship na yun, medyo nahirapan po ako or nagsistruggle po ako
uh-huh.
na i-direct yung path ko uh-huh. towards chastity.
Uh-huh.
Since also, I'm not just a part of the LGBT, but I'm also a servant
mm-hmm.
sa parish namin.
Mm-hmm.
And then, since, ayun nga po, nag-explore ako, may point po na parang nagsastruggle po ako and nagkakaroon na po ako ng parang addiction, hindi lang po sa
mm-hmm.
pornography or masturbation, but also dun sa sexual relation
mm-hmm.
between same-sex po.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And although kaka-break lang po namin ng recent kong boyfriend
mm-hmm.
na which is much older from me po
mm-hmm.
mga 5 years
mm-hmm.
Although na nakikip naman po namin yung promise namin before
mm-hmm.
na to keep chastity as much as possible
mm-hmm.
nagsastruggle po talaga kasi parang sa tingin ko po ano eh yung sexual urge po talaga is sobrang lakas lalo na po sa yung time po namin yun. Aside po kasi sa college life ko ngayon.
Mm-hmm.
Yung ano din po kasi parang yung peers parang malaki din po siyang factor kung bakit parang hindi na na-force but parang mm-hmm. na-drive ako doon sa ganung path of life po.
Okay.
So ayun po.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for sharing your background to us, no? And we affirm your situation and we acknowledge that this kind of stories, especially now that you are embodying the very story you're telling, really exists. And it's a reality that we must also try to accept with charity, but at the same time with caution. And I'm happy and relieved in the knowledge that although you might be struggling from your being a member of the LGBTQ community and at the same time serving in your parish, you still opt hopefully to continue. Do you?
Yes, sir.
Very good. No, I think here we can navigate with our desires. No, both your desires in the light of your wanting and yearning for service and for love and devotion to God, but at the same time, the desire on the other end, as you mentioned it. Very curious case desires are, you see. And I hope we very well navigate both through those two ways of desiring. But perhaps you may want to educate us a little more on your label as a pansexual for the sake of some of us who may not be too familiar with it. Do you mind telling us something about it?
Yes. So, marami po nako-confuse between bisexual and pansexual. So, basically po, pag bisexual, nakatingin lang po or nakataon lang po yung konsepto niya na hindi lang po siya na-attract sa opposite niya but also dun sa same sex. So, pwede siya sa straight man and pwede rin siya sa straight woman. Yun sa bisexual. Yun sa pansexual po kasi, theoretically speaking, if pag-usapan natin yung pansexual, to anyone, pwede siya ma-attract to anyone. So, hindi lang siya nakulong sa girl, sa boy. Pwede din siya ma-attract sa transgender, transsexual, sa lesbian, and also sa gay.
So, regardless or irrespective of your, of anyone's GI and GE,
yes,
pansexual is open to that.
Yes.
Did I get it correctly?
Yes, po. Yung attract.
Attraction. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for clearing that out. No, kasi these are new terms to us and I think the church has to learn how to embrace them as well. No? Not totally for the sake of, you know, approving them, but at least that awareness, no? That awareness that this exists. No, thank you very much for being a living witness to this kind of situation. So, kanina, you were mentioning about, it seems to me now, your dilemma. Tama ba ako? I'm sorry if I'm labeling it this way, no? The dilemma of keeping yourself and your partner's vow to being chaste, although in a committed relationship, and at the same time, you know, being tempted to engage in manners that are somehow considered, if not taken in moderation, addictive. You mentioned about pornography, you mentioned about masturbation, and even sexual relations perhaps with your partner. How do you go about it? I mean, how do you reconcile if there's this battle ongoing between your inner desire, no, to keep remain chaste, and at the same time when temptation would come its way to, you know, to really convince you during those difficult moments, how do you measure, no, how do you go about it?
Most of the time hindi po talaga nagiging good yung outcome sa pag-cope up ko sa mga ganun sa mga ganung situations. Kasi kadalasan po talaga sobrang lakas ng urge. Kahit na po sabihin natin, firm ka dun sa stand mo and firm ka sa gusto mong gawin. Sa akin po, as a person, nagfe-fail po ako na parang i-keep yung ganung relationship. And sometimes ako din yung nagiging reason why nagkakaroon kami ng, or nagko-commit kami ng sin. Ang pinakang parang coping mechanism ko lang po dun, every time na parang nandun po yung urge to do such sins.
Mm.
Ang ginagawa ko lang po is parang to divert yung attention ko and yung energy ko sa ibang bagay. For example po, sa organization, papagurin ko yung sarili ko doon. Para pag-uwi ng bahay, wala nang chance, kumbaga, na parang mag-exert pa ng kung anong interest mo na gawin.
That's I think commendable on your part, no? The sense of awareness na kailangan ko sigurong mas maging produktibo sa ibang bagay, no? And I even commend yourself for strength if you can overcome this every now and then. Pero yun nga, gaya ng sinabi mo, recurring yung urge. And it's really hard to resist them. Let me put it this way. Nasaan yung konteksto nung kagustuhan din ng partner mo to engage? By what you said, did I get it correctly? You're implying pareho ba kayong nagsiserve? Or hindi naman?
Dati po siyang single.
Okay.
May ganun din.
Okay. So, he's very much aware of this also.
Yes,
this
po.
Dissonance and dilemma, if I may call so. And siya din nagsastruggle.
Yes, ma'am.
And both of you have this sense of awareness as well.
Yes, po.
Okay. So, you just mentioned you broke up.
Yes.
So, at the moment, sorry if I may just ask, no, a bit too personal, are you now in a committed relationship?
Now po, wala na.
Okay. So, with that answer, can I take it like as if you're telling me na recently, kahit papaano, you're able to manage those urges because at least you are not in a relationship that would really be an avenue or a factor. It's really a big factor kasi if you are in a committed relationship, is it not?
Apo.
Yeah, oo. So, sa ngayon, medyo kahit papano, from the looks of it, no? From the way you're telling me, kahit papano, you're flaring well in your trying to remain chaste. That's yes. From your words. And again, I commend you. And I believe baka nga mas magaling ka pa sa akin in matters of church doctrines, no? I think irrespective of whether or not we identify as LGBTQIA+, or as either straight, heterosexual man or woman, I think irrespective of all these labels, there is this one universal call to holiness. And I very much appreciate the fact that you are aware of it, no? The call for us to remain holy and for us to perhaps hopefully cling on to that desire of being holy, isa dun yung kagustuhan natin na nawa, mamuhay tayong busilak at chaste.
Yes.
So, I could not particularly offer a perfect formula. But so long as I think you nourish in you the desire to be with God, other than that desire or urge for sexual pleasure, I think you would be able to form in you a sort of a defense, if I may call it, no? Kasi nasa sa iyo yun eh, kung alin ang mas nangingibabaw, no? Kung alin yung mas nais ng puso, ano yung hangal, ano yung ibig. You know, it's interesting because both what you desire or yearn for and what you usually run away from, it's actually just simply within you. Kung ano yung kadalasang hinahanap mo at tinatakbuhan mo, parehong nasa iyo. Ano yun? Pagmamahal. Pag-ibig. And we know very well that God manifests Himself as love. Baka yung desire na mga nararamdaman mo, we can channel it in a more charitable way. In a more loving way. I do not know if it would help you if you are aware of your partners or yourselves love language. But perhaps instead of engaging much on the desires of the flesh, you can lavish your love through words of affirmation, right? Or acts of service. You already mentioned it from your story a while ago. Kasi hindi dapat na nagiging hadlang, no? Yung kagustuhan natin na magkaroon ng companion, na gugustuhan nating magkaroon ng karelasyon upang tayo'y manatiling banal. Again, that's the universal call for us to all maintain holiness and keep ourselves rooted in the Lord. I just hope this doesn't diminish also the reality that you are undergoing at the moment. Little by little, I hope you will be able to go through it in a way that is not punitive, but accepting. Yung sana hindi mo naman nararamdaman na pinarurusahan ka, bangkus, inaanalayan pa nga. Ganun kabuti yung pag-ibig ng Diyos. Thank you for giving us this testimony.
Thank you, po.
Is there any other struggle, perhaps in a more detailed way, that you may want us to hear you out and listen to your story?
Ayun, as na-mention ko na rin po na church servant po. Para kasing meron po sa sarili ko na parang nararamdaman ko parang madalas na parang ayoko na lang mag-serve kasi parang at the end of the day, ino-offend ko pa rin yung si God while at the same time, pinipleased ko yung sarili ko, sinasatisfy ko yung sarili ko sa mga bagay na alam ko namang offensive sa kanya. So, most of the time po parang, ewan ko, pero nafe-feel ko masakit para sa akin kasi, ayun nga, sobrang lapit ko sa simbahan but yung reality na ginagawa ko is parang hindi ko siya talaga mapigilan or makontrol na. Since, ayun nga po, parang medyo matagal na rin yung span ng time na na-spend ko sa ganung way of life po.
But I'm happy you continue with your service, no? I hope until now you still commit to serve in your ways, possibly. No? Although other peoples may see it like, you know, dismissive na, uy, wag natin pag-serving kasi, you know, with this kind of confession now, especially once this will be aired.
Yes.
Of course, we have to realize that there might be like some consequence. But I hope our church, we as the church, would be more accepting and understanding that this is a real struggle. And cliche as it may sound, Pope Francis repeatedly said, who am I to judge? And I hope that can be the same disposition that we carry. And I hope you continue nurturing that desire in your heart. Not to sin, but to desire God more.
Yeah.
I'm just happy that you know your true desire from your words, no? At gusto mo patuloy na maglingkod eh. Nasa sa iyo iyon. Cultivate that, no? Cultivate with prayer, with penance, no? Perhaps it would really help you a lot when you are also in a community that would not necessarily, you know, promote, but at the same time, hindi rin naman yung sobrang judgment sa'yo. Yung community, alam mo, yayakapin ka.
Yes po.
Pero sa pagyakap, may pagtutuwid. Sana mahanap mo ito sa simbahan natin. No? Kasi there are a lot of people who are very much willing to accompany you. So, we are here to accompany. And by listening to you, I think that's already a good form of accompaniment. Thank you. Please keep telling your story. There may be no like clear resolution, but again, after all, it's a matter between you and your God. So long as you are true to your desire for Him, so long as you are true to your commitment to Him, again, who are we to judge? Who are we to judge? So thank you very much, and
thank you,
God bless you.
Thank you, Bob.
So, pwede na kayong tumayo at mag-tina.
Kinala ko ba to? Ay! Kinala ko ba? No, nasa PCN din to, di ba? I see in you, dear.
The gender ideology that is becoming more prevalent now in our times, especially in the context of social acceptance and church tolerance, hopefully can be dealt with more compassion and charity than dismissiveness. Ang kwentong ating narinig at napakinggan ay isang patunay na may nagbabangga ang puwersa sa puso ng isang taong nakakaranas ng ganitong uri ng pangsubok. The challenge to both remain committed to one's desire for God and the desire of this world, fleshly and earthly desires. And it's interesting on how we can weigh both desires in such a way that hopefully it can both offer us not only clarity, but in the long run, healing. Sa kwento ng ating confessi, binigyan mo pansin yung katotohanan na maraming kabataan ang nag-explore ng gender, sexual orientation. And as workers in youth accompaniment, we have also to equip ourselves with the terms or perhaps with this ideology. Not because we want to make an approval of it, but simply because we want to understand them better. Sa ating kagustuhang maunawaan ang ating mga kabataang pinaglilingkuran, nawa, huwag natin isara ang ating mga isip, puso at diwa upang samahan sila sa kanilang kaguluhan, if I may call it, kaguluhan ng isip, no? Some problems with discernment, with whether they would keep themselves committed to their promise to be changed or to engage in what their urging desires would tell them to commit. Nawa ang kwentong ito ay magsilbing pamukaw, panggising, ang tapik na malaman natin nangyayari ang mga pakinggan. At dahil nangyayari siya, dapat nating pag-usapan, dapat nating pakinggan, at kalaunan, dapat nating gawa ng paraan. We have to do something about it. Perhaps we could place programs as to how we can practice radical hospitality towards our brothers and sisters who may be struggling with this. And in so doing, we can likewise let them feel the radical love and charity of Jesus. Thank you very much, and God bless you.